This episode is brought to you by Paramount Plus. Ewan McGregor stars as Count Alexander Rostov in A Gentleman in Moscow, the new limited series based on the best-selling novel. Stream it on March 29th with the Paramount Plus with Showtime plan. Visit ParamountPlus.com to try it free.
When you hear this, what do you feel? At IMAX, you'll feel transported by our unique sound system and crystal clear images. Like you're running across a desert planet or defending your city from a surprise invasion. With immersive IMAX sound and screens curved to show more, we take fans to the edge of their seats. Get tickets to Dune Part 2 now and experience it in IMAX's exclusive expanded aspect ratio.
Join Jessica Smith on Lead Like a Girl podcast, where she defies odds, shares inspiring stories, and empowers women to embrace their inner leaders. Tune in for a transformative journey.
Happy Wednesday, Lead Like a Girl family. I want to start off by just once again thanking you all for your support, for your consistent listening, for your sharing. I really appreciate you all for going on this journey with me. I would like to take a little break away from my regular program here. So I'm going to step away from my story for a moment because I want to use today and this episode to just really dedicate some time to sharing what is on my heart in regards to my grandfather. So this past week, my grandfather has transitioned and he is no longer with us. And even though, of course, I am sad, this has been an opportunity for me to just stop and reflect. And of course, that's what happens, right? We lose someone close to us, and it's always this moment, I hope, for most of us, a moment of reflection where we stop and we think about, wow, life is short, right? And we think about what have I done with my life so far? And for me, you know, Will and I talk a lot with our children, and some of the buzzwords in our house, other than just family, is legacy. We talk a lot with our children about legacy and what that means to us as a family and what we hope that it means to them. And I often ask myself, what do you want to be known for? Right? Like, even in the present, what do you want to be known for? You hear me talk a lot about building your network and building your brand. And that ties into your brand. What do you want to be known for? But then that next level is, we all have an expiration date, right? We're all going to check out of here at some point in time. And someone, they're going to speak words at our funeral. What do you want them to say about you. So when I'm talking to younger people and they're asking me about, oh, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I don't know what I'm meant to do. And you've heard me say this before. Reflect on your story. Think about the gifts that God gave you. And usually putting those together and somewhere in between there is what you're supposed to do. And so tying all this into where I'm at today and thinking about my grandfather. So, and I hope I have this right. I think my grandfather was 97 years old. Let's just say 97, 90, whatever he was almost 100 years old. 100 years he spent on this earth. Like, wow. I really hope and pray that I am blessed enough to spend that many years on this earth. And I listened to, I want to say it was Pastor Paul, and he said something, and I wrote it down because I wanted to make sure I got it right. And he said something like, how dare you check out of here before you finish the work that you were put here to do. And I've been really spending some time in prayer and meditation since my grandfather passed on Sunday. And I thought about that. And I thought, okay, legacy, what you were put here to do, your story, all of that. Now, my grandfather in his early years, he battled with an addiction of alcoholism. And from what I understand, it was a pretty brutal battle. Before my time here. Because by the time I met my grandfather, he was a man of God, like a real man of God. I remember that he owned a small barber shop in a suburb outside of Chicago. And he dressed very well. He always had on a pair of slacks and a buttoned up collared shirt, pressed very nicely. Of course, his hair was always cut. He was always clean shaved. And even though English wasn't his first language, he spoke very good English. He was a family man. He wasn't around a lot because of his battle when his children were young. I understand he was in and out of the home. But he raised a couple of his grandchildren as his own. As him and my grandmother were in their later years. I mean, they were already in their probably 40s, 50s, if not older, and still raising two of their grandchildren. They were always very giving, loving grandparents. My grandmother is still alive. We don't know for how much longer because that was her one and only love. So my grandfather owned this barber shop, and when you sat in his chair, didn't matter what your belief was, he was going to tell you a story. And so I know that I actually got my passion for storytelling on both sides, but my grandfather loved to tell stories. In particular, he loved to tell the story of Jesus Christ. And it didn't matter who you were from whatever walks of life or whatever your belief system was, he was going to open that book and tell you about the love of God. I did take my first family vacation with my grandfather. We went to Texas. And I remember being with a couple of other cousins. And I just remember the joy it brought my grandfather to travel and to go on vacations. He was big on taking his vacation to Texas every year. That meant a lot to him. He eventually retired, and him and my grandmother lived in a small house in Lake in the Hills, Illinois. And he gave generously. He served. I remember my grandmother complaining about him always giving so much money to the church. And she used to say, he just keeps giving more and more and more. My grandfather was a generous man, a smart man. And one of the things I remember the most is that he really carried a heavy burden for his family. He wanted his family to know the Lord. And what I know for sure is that I wasn't the only one that was impacted by that. I know that his children and his grandchildren and his great-grandchildren and his great-great-grandchildren were all impacted by that. My grandfather taught us how to pray. He taught us how to read the Bible. And in many cases, I remember him sitting at the breakfast table and he would talk about things and then he would say, I'll show you where it says that in the Bible. And I wonder, as I think back, did I have a confused look on my face or a look of disbelief? When he would have those moments and he would say, I will show you where it says that in the Bible. And he would get up and he would go and get that Bible and he would show you. And even though I did not know what the heck he was talking about, one day I did. One day I did. He planted seeds and they mattered. I know that as I travel to Chicago and have the opportunity to sit with family and just reminisce, for me, this is not a time for mourning. This is a time for celebration. Because what I know is that my grandfather carried out his purpose here. He completed his assignments here. And as he is in his resting place during this resting time, he is at peace. He is no longer in pain. He was ready. He did everything he was supposed to do. And when the day comes that he is able to stand in front of his Heavenly Father, there is no doubt in my mind that the words that he will hear is, well done, my faithful servant. My grandfather also had a really great sense of humor. He was really a funny dude. Sometimes he had, you know, corny jokes because they were like totally like, you know, dad jokes, but he was funny. He had a great sense of humor and he loved to laugh. And he was always happy. And he made it clear where his joy and happiness came from. He loved kids. And I'm so grateful that even the youngest, I don't know if they're the youngest, but they are some of the youngest, my brother Paul's children, that he got to see them. Now, his eyesight wasn't the best, but he got to meet them and hear them. And I know that brought him joy. My grandfather used to make the best homemade tortillas ever. They were so good. And he had so much pride in those tortillas. He loved making them and they just smelled so good and they were so warm. And in the morning, and do not dare say no, thank you, when he offered you tortillas in the morning. You don't tell my grandfather, no, thank you. So whether you wanted them or not, you said, yes, please. And they were so good. And they were warm and they were fresh and they came right out of the pan. I am so thankful for the memories that I have of my grandfather. I don't take those for granted because my dad's mom or dad, I never had the opportunity to meet. And I know plenty of people who never had the chance to experience grandparents? I'm so grateful. I'm so thankful that I have the memories that I do. I hope that I can make my grandchildren as proud of my legacy as I am of my grandfather's. I hope that as he is always with us in spirit, that I can make him proud, that I can make him proud of the seeds that he planted in the early years as he did. He had a dream and a desire that his children would know the Lord, and they do, that his grandchildren and his great-grandchildren, and I believe that they will because of the sacrifices that he made. He fought his battle and he won. And I am grateful. I love you, Grandpa.
Thank you for tuning in to another insightful episode of Lead Like a Girl. We hope you found today's podcast valuable. If you enjoyed our podcast, please consider subscribing and leaving a review on your preferred platform. Your feedback is crucial in helping us continue to provide high-quality content. If you found the content inspiring, we would like to encourage you to share this podcast with your network. Stay tuned for more inspiring stories and leadership insights on Lead Like a Girl. Until next time, lead with passion and purpose.